If you're thinking about selling your house, then you're in the right place, because in this video, we're gonna go over 5 common mistakes that sellers make when selling their house. Hi, this is Joe Eslait with Casa Real Estate, and in this channel, we talk about all things real estate and about living here in Rochester, Minnesota. Mistake number one that sellers make is setting an unrealistic price. The longer that your home sits on the market, which by the way, the current days on the market right now in Rochester, Minnesota is 2 weeks. So anything longer than 2 weeks, buyers are gonna start wondering and asking themselves, well, why hasn't this home sold? Why has it been in the market for, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, couple months, right? So make sure you set the price of your home to sell. Also, by overpricing your home, you're missing the chance of connecting with buyers that are ready to go and that would buy your house, but they're not because the house is overpriced. Mistake number two is having poor photos of your home. One of my biggest pet peeves is when I see homes for sale with really bad pictures that have bad lighting or a shaky image and just doesn't look very professional at all. Make sure you hire a professional photographer that will come into your house and take high definition quality pictures. By working with a professional real estate agent, this is a service that you will automatically get by working with that agent, and you'll have really beautiful pictures. Mistake number three is to hide major problems. Now, in the state of Minnesota, it is illegal to not disclose or to hide any major defects or issues that the home may have that may affect the use or enjoyment of the next buyer. And so you're gonna have to disclose any major problems, but oftentimes I see sellers that will list their home and put it for sale and they won't fix, carpet that's stained or that needs to basically be replaced, or maybe they have a leak and you can see the stain on the ceiling, and they'll just kind of hope that the buyer won't care and maybe the inspector won't bring it up or say anything. And more often than not, it pays to just have those things fixed. That way you have time to have it fixed, pick the person or the contractor that you want to have it done, and that'll help you save money, because a lot of times after the inspection, between inspection and the closing date, if you have to rush and get someone in to fix it, it might end up costing you more money. So make sure that anything that, if you were buying the house, you wouldn't have to deal with, just take care of it, have it fixed, and it will definitely pay off when you sell your home. Mistake number four is not preparing for the sale. So make sure that when you're putting your home for sale, make sure that you have it cleaned, even if that's like hiring a professional person to come and clean your home, or if you wanna do it yourself, obviously that's fine too. But just make sure you clean like the front door, windows. The more detail you are, the better, because it'll definitely show when someone comes in to see the house. As you're cleaning, make sure that you also declutter your home. If you have a closet that you, in the last couple years, have just been like stuffing things in, which is normal, I do that in my house. But if you're selling your house, make sure that you take the time to declutter that closet, clean it up, and make sure that it looks organized and spacious, because that's very important. When you work with a professional real estate agent, they're gonna help you, guide you, and give you tips with what you should declutter, organize. Cleaning is pretty obvious, but also they'll help you, guide you with that part as well. And then lastly, staging is very important. You don't always have to hire a professional stager to come in and stage your whole entire home, but just having someone that can help you reorganize and kind of guide you through that process of better placing your furniture and things in your house so that everything looks great and is ready to go when you sell your home. Mistake number five is not accommodating buyers. Selling your house can be a lot of work, and there's many parts and factors that go into selling your house, but one of the things that you don't wanna skip is having the ability to accommodate for buyers when they wanna come see the house. The timing, some buyers can only come in the evenings or some can come early in the morning. So the more flexible you can be with the timing of when people can see your home, the better. And then also making sure that when they come see the house, that you organize it, that it looks, really clean and ready to go for them to see it and have the best experience possible. I know this can be like a lot of work, but it will definitely pay off when you're selling your home. If you would like more information about selling your house, I'm gonna have a link on the video descriptions below with an extensive guide on selling your house, and that will be very helpful if you are thinking about selling. Hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or anything, I'm never too busy to help you with any of your real estate needs.